Well, good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. Whenever you're watching this video, welcome to, or welcome back to, my e-bike adventures. So, what are we doing today? Well, some of you may have guessed from looking behind, because that is indeed train tracks. So, we're going on the train with my e-bike, but not just any train, because we're going to go on one of the smallest steam trains in the southeast of England. This isn't the particular train I'm getting on, but this is indicative of the size of the train that we're going on. And essentially, we're going to Romney Sands today, and from there we're going to move on and ride on to Camber Sands, where, so I've seen, there's a very, very nice cafe that I want to check out and see what the grub's like. So I've got a little bit of a wait until the train comes into the station, so about 45 minutes. So unfortunately I missed the train coming here, but I'll explain that in a bit more detail in a bit. Anyway, I'll catch you when we're going to board the train. Catch you in a bit. So this is the route we're taking. We're starting off at Hythe at the top, 5 miles to Dinchurch, 6 miles to St Mary's Bay, 7.5 miles to Romney Warren Holt, 8.5 miles to New Romney, and 10.5 to Romney Sands. So that's gonna cut out a big amount of our journey. And then there we go, there's some, a little bit of history about the areas and what you can expect there. And then we've got steam railway facts along the wall, in case you wanted to know how steam engines all work. It's a very informative poster here, telling you everything you need to know. Just means we need to wait for the train. Here we are. My train is just rolling in. Well, the train's on the bike, the bike's on the train. And so you can see there's still plenty of room. I was a bit worried about that, to be honest. Cool. Well, I'm on the train. Oh, it's so hot today. But yeah, we're all here. I'll just show you the bike. Voila, the bike is on the train. Obviously they only have limited amount of space on the train, so yeah, a big bike like mine is pretty much taking up most of the space. I believe they can fit about 4 normal bikes, and I'd probably say 2 of these bikes at a push would get on here, no problem. No, I mean, actually thinking about it, 2 bikes of this stature would get on this train. But yeah. Whew. Anyway, I thought it'd be nice. I have been threatening on bringing you along on this steam train for some time. So yeah, here we are, finally doing it. The weather is absolutely gorgeous today. It's so hot. it's quite a stark contrast from all the other times, really, because 24 degrees today, and we've been lucky to been hitting 15, 17 degrees of late. So yeah, it's quite a stark contrast. But I'm looking forward to the journey, and then when we get off, I need to go to Camber Sands. I did have one little problem getting here, and that's essentially why I'm late. So I put a new throttle on the Ranger. Now, the Ranger is my favourite bike at the moment. Well, it's one of my favourite bikes, but I don't have a rack on it. It's just purely for enjoying riding rather than taking lots of stuff with you, etc., you know. So I don't have a rear rack on the bike, you know. There's nothing on the bike that enables me to carry anything. So yeah, but yeah, let me just show you if I can. So as you can see, I had to move this throttle slightly out because I couldn't engage the up shift on the gears because it was banging against the back of this whole handlebar. So I've had to move this slightly along this way, and the handlebar, as you can see, there is a little mark. So I haven't moved it an awful lot, but enough that makes a bit of a difference for me. Whew. Right, also, what else? So I've got something new that you haven't seen me in yet, and that's a cycle helmet. And actually, this one fits. So happy days. The straps at the moment, I have worn it, they don't sort of flatten my ears, or the strap doesn't cut into the back of my ears. So yes, fantastic, finally. But also, I mean, cyrusher sent me this hat. This, thank you very much, cyrusher, as always. And also, if you press the back, you've got a light. And also, you've got a light on the front. Now, these lights will last for 8 hours on a full charge. So also, there's another, if you press it again, let me press it again, then it flashes red and amber, and the light on the front still stays the same. And then another press, the flashing amber and green, red again, with no light on the front. And then once more, turns them both off. So yeah, really, really handy. And safety wise, top notch. Right, it just, we're just gonna wait for the train to start a moving. We're just getting about ready to leave. So you can see the steam from the front train. And we have movement. We're off. Bike's a bit wobbly. Gonna have to keep my eye on that so we don't fall over. There's the chain. I don't know if you can hear me all right on here because it's quite loud. I've had to move the bike over to the other side because essentially this was bouncing about all over the place, and I've still got my leg up against the tire to keep it there. Probably should have bought some bungee straps and just tied it to those handles there. Oh my god. Yeah, that's not the best. Right. Hopefully we survive this journey. Or the bike does at the very least. Means Rodney Sands is the next stop. So yeah, we just got one more stop and then we'll be at Rodney Sands essentially. So we're almost there. So yeah, this can be a little bit expensive. So my price, my ticket for today, which was a single, because I'm essentially intending to ride all the way back, That cost me £18. So I believe the bike was £4 to transport that. That's essentially £4 single or return. So £4 for your bike. So yeah, it's cost me £14 for a ticket. A little bit expensive possibly, but to be honest with you, I mean, this place is a great place to bring the family. A great day out. So if you're in the area, yeah, hook up on the light railway from Hythe to Hythe to Dymchurch. No, Hythe to Dungeness. I don't even know where I'm going. Oh. Yeah, I know where I'm going. I'm getting off at the next stop. Anyway, we're on the move again. Catch you in a bit. Amazing, there's the loads of train sets in people's gardens that we've passed.
Hello doggy.
But yeah, so I didn't want to film other people's gardens, but you know, if you're in the area, come on the light railway from Hythe to Dungeness and you'll see for yourself. Absolutely beautiful ride. Now, I'm just waiting to get to Romney Sands and then we can get off and get moving again, but on the bike. I think, basically, I think we're just about to come into Romney Sands, sorry. So I'm gonna switch the camera off. I need to get the bike out, catch it in a bit. Right, we got off the light railway at Romney Sands, so, I'm just going to pop my map and find my route to Camber Sands and then I'll join you in a bit on the road. But we'll just wait and watch this train go out. Just look at this though, isn't it beautiful?
It certainly is.
On the bike and we're on the way heading off to Camber Sands. Oh, there's a bird cheeping. I don't know if you heard that, but it sounds exactly like my camera switching off. Oh. Had me going for a bit. And really, I've got my my Google Maps up, but unfortunately, I've had to keep my phone in my pocket because I don't have anywhere left on the handlebar where I can essentially put my phone mount. Well, I could put it there, but unfortunately it's going to be angled
like that and I won't be able to read it. So I'm gonna have to, unfortunately. Oh, Google Maps is actually telling me something. I can hear it in my pocket. And for some reason, as always,
it's not... Turn right onto Curtain Road.
Right, okay, turn right. Thank you very much. So, actually, I don't even know. I think you can see me all right on that camera. So what do you think to my new helmet? On my head, you dirty fools. The only thing I'd say is I feel like I'm sweating a lot more on my head now I'm wearing this, but you know, for safety's sake, I think I can learn to live with it. I've got a couple of beautiful lakes to the left and the right of me as well at the moment. Also, my apologies. Today I've only got two cameras, one on my chest, one on the front of the bike. I've got more bike mounts, camera mounts arriving, but they're not here yet. So unfortunately, we're not gonna have that rear facing camera today. But man, what a beautiful day. Supposed to be 24 degrees. And yeah, it's quite a contrast to what we've been having of late. I mean, we're in the middle of summer. And it's been rain, 15 degrees. On good days, 17 possibly. And now we got one day where it's just suddenly 24 degrees. And that's really quite a big lift up, to be honest. That's like 8 degrees increase. But hopefully, I'll get a little bit of a tan today and get some colour in my skin. Hello, horses, to my right and to my left. I'm just going to pull in just for a moment. Oh my goodness, it's so beautiful, so warm. Oh, recenter.
Okay. So I want to go up here and I want Dolphin Road. It's a little bit of a pain not having my my navigation on the handlebar though. I think I go over on this roundabout. To turn left there. Anyway, let's go the right way around the roundabout. Just hope I'm not going to be too late, and that this they haven't stopped serving food where I want to go, because it looks lovely. Now there's not many food establishments in Canberra Sands. I think there's four, so they're quite limited. But this one had the top marks. So I thought, you know what, let's go give it a go. Let's do something a little bit different. Because, you know, if my adventures are all the same week in, week out, it won't really feel like an adventure. It'll just feel like I'm doing the same thing. There's a wind farm over there, but it doesn't look like they're actually moving today. One of them is. Only one out of all of that. Which seems really odd. Oh, I can see two moving now, three moving. So, seems a bit inefficient to only have three going. Well, no, have they all started up now? It looks like they're all starting to start up, actually. So, maybe they've had to move them for a change in wind direction. But yeah, many of them are just starting up now. Right, I'm going to pull over in a second. And I'm going to switch both of these cameras off, because I'm not really sure how much further I am away. And I kind of want to have those cameras on as I approach where I'm heading. Fucking hell. What the actual fuck? Caught on camera, dude. Fucking idiot. You're a fucking idiot. Thank you.
I'm going to pull over here because hey, that guy just pretty much scared the shit out of me there, driving way too close and he didn't need to. So yeah, I'm going to turn that camera off and this camera off, so I'll see you in a bit. Well, I finally made it to Canvas Sands, on, well, the beach anyway, and then if I pan round, we can see the wind farm over there. So most of them are just starting up, so we're about, I'd say about 10 or 15 minutes from our location. So I'm going to switch the bike cameras on, we'll get rolling again. Right, well, I'm just about to go down the slope and rejoin the road because we're not very far from where we're heading. I need to turn left after this playground. And hopefully the place I'm looking for should be on the left. Just down here a little bit. I think we're here. I'm here, I'm at the Rye Bay Bar and Grill,
have all to myself. A nice recorderly, a glass of ice. Oh, because this is thirsty work. My hand's shaking. Cheers. Right, I'm just gonna sit back and relax and wait for my meal. But yeah, I mean, this place looks really quite nice, to be honest. And literally, the beach is right the other side of me, or right behind the camera, essentially. So yeah, we're not very far, essentially. So I'm just, like I said, I'm gonna sit back and relax now and get my breath back, enjoy my cider, and I'll show you when my meal arrives. Catch in a bit. Well, look at that. Absolutely looks gorgeous. And this little lot, including my cider, come to £16, which isn't bad, because that's all freshly cooked, freshly made. Anyway, enough of looking at it, I'm going to tuck in. Well, I've got to say, the Rye Bay Bar and Grill, absolutely gorgeous meal. Yeah, absolute top notch, well worth the money. Absolutely delicious, really, really filling. I couldn't fault it, to be honest with you. It seems like it's quite a local hangout as well, and I had quite a few nice chats as well with people as well. So a really friendly environment. So if you are in the area, Canberra Sands, I'd sort of recommend that you go and check it out, to be honest, because gets a big thumbs up from me. Right, I'm kind of all set and ready. I'm gonna get back out on my Ranger. Right, let's get out of the way of pontins, because we've got to head home. And I've got a 30 mile bike ride ahead of me now. In the sunshine, in the heat. But yeah, absolutely beautiful meal, beautiful location. Couldn't recommend it enough, if I'm honest. One last little look at the beach, and as you can see, this sand stretches for miles. Absolutely gorgeous beach. So I'm just going to say thank you once again for watching this video. If you like this kind of content, then hit that like and subscribe button. And also, don't forget, you can hit that bell notification as well to get notified when I upload a video every Monday morning. So that just leaves me to say thank you ever so much for watching, coming along for the ride. A big thank you to all my subscribers, and just know that
I really appreciate you all. We got past those people safely, because it's all about being safe, isn't it? You know, I've said my goodbyes, so I'm just going to leave the cameras rolling until essentially they run out of battery, because I've got a 30 mile journey ahead of me now to get home, so they're not going to last. They won't last that time. So, again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all again next week. Take care. Bye-bye. Ka-chunk, 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 ka-chunk. Oh, gaps in the road. It's almost like slabs of tarmac were laid and they didn't join them together. Because I feel like they're quite evenly spread apart. There's a big crack between both. Right, let's just turn off here, because should we quickly go and say hello to the sheep? It's always nice to say hello to the local wildlife. Meh. Oh look, they do their usual one and run away from me. Oh, don't run away, Mr. Sheep. Well, sorry for disturbing your day. I'll be off now. So bye bye. Bye bye, Mr. and Mrs. Sheeps. Chest camera gone, so there's only this one left. That one doesn't pick up very well on my audio. Essentially this one is used for that. So thanks again for making it this far, and I'll see you all next week for a new adventure. Oh, just look at this line of sheep, all in a line,
all single filed. Look at them. Does this follow the leader? Hey, Mr. Sheeps. Just look at them though. Absolutely crazy that they're all in single file. Oh, they queue better than most humans, you know. Maybe that's the entrance up there. Are they going to a party?
Hi.
Hiya. And a fellow cyclist just rode past. Very friendly one at that. Oh, look at you guys go. And there's a swan over there. Ducks, geese, all right over there. And of course, the wind farm off in the distance, where it seems only a few again are going. I'm not sure why, there's quite a bit of wind going today, so. Anyway, oh,